Esther chapter 7. So the king and Haman went to dine with Queen Esther, and as they were drinking wine on the second day, the king again asked, "Queen Esther, what is your petition? It will be given you. What is your request? Even up to half of the kingdom, it will be granted." Then Queen Esther answered, "If I have found favor with you, O king, and if it pleases your majesty, grant me my life. This is my petition, and spare my people. This is my request, for I and my people have been sold for destruction and slaughter and annihilation. If we had merely been sold as male and female slaves, I would have kept quiet. But because no such distress would justify disturbing the king, King Xerxes asked Queen Esther, 'Who is he? Where is the man who has dared to do such a thing?' Esther said, 'The adversary and enemy is this vile Haman.' Then Haman was terrified before the king and queen. The king got up in a rage, left his wine, and went out into the palace garden. But Haman, realizing that the king had already decided his fate, stayed behind to beg Queen Esther for his life. Just as the king returned from the palace to the banquet hall, Haman was falling on the couch where Esther was reclining. The king exclaimed, 'Will he even molest the queen while she is with me in the house?' As soon as the word left the king's mouth, they covered Haman's face. Then Habona, one of the eunuchs attending the king, said, 'A gallows 75 feet high stands by Haman's house. He made it for Mordecai, who spoke up to help the king.' The king said, 'Hang him on it.' So they hanged Haman on the gallows he prepared for Mordecai. Then the king's fury subsided.